Good afternoon and welcome to this lecture of CADCAM. We were discussing in previous lecture about computer aided process planning. Today we will continue this. Let me share the screen. Is it visible to you? Can anyone just send me a message? Is it visible? Yes, okay. Thank you, Sopne. So let us just remind quickly what we have discussed in last lecture. We were discussing about computer aided process planning. We have seen what is mean by process planning, how it is bridging between design phase and manufacturing phase, what exactly mean by process plan, what does it constitutes, what are the different things it has as a feature. We have seen a diagrammatical representation of a process planning, what are the inputs, what are the outputs we are going to get by using process planning, what are the constraints, then basic processes in developing a process plan that we have already discussed. There are two types of approaches as we have discussed, manual system and with the help of computer. So manual system we have discussed how it is going to work, what are its features, its advantages, disadvantages, and by using computer help how process planning is carried out, that we have already discussed. And we have discussed a variant or retrieval type computer aided process planning. We have seen this example where a new part was to be manufactured, and as an planning engineer or as an shop floor engineer, you have to plan regarding the process of manufacturing this part, and you have these two parts out of which this part is quite similar to this part, so you are going to use this part program or process plan for this particular part here as a basis part or a base part, a base plan for this part. Okay, this is how we are going to use that. We have seen the general procedure for using a retrieval type computer aided process planning, how to retrieve the part family, how to retrieve the plan in the process, and we have seen the advantages and disadvantages. Now today we are going to discuss about generative type CAPP, that is generative type computer aided process planning. So if you see or if you observe, the name itself denotes what type of process planning it is. Generative type, it generates. So basically, since we are having a computer aided process planning, in first session we have discussed manual type and also a computer type, but this is a generative computer type. Okay, so what does the definition tells us? A generative process planning system is a system which automatically generates a process plan. Keep this in mind. This generative system develops or generates process plan automatically. So here a role of computer is more as compared to the other types. Okay, now what are the feature, what are the requirements for this generative type CAPP? It must have the knowledge of manufacturing. The knowledge of manufacturing is required for generative process planning. It is possible to construct an optimum operation sequence. Operation sequence means what is the first operation to be performed, what is the second operation to be performed, how you are going to convert a raw material to the final product, that is a operation sequence, and you have to optimize it. Optimization means choosing the best possible option available from the sequences. It is not like that for a particular product you will have one process, then second process, then third process and fourth process. There will be no standardization, right? There will be options. You can go for first operation at the first level, third operation at the second level, fourth operation at the third level, like that. So there are number of possibilities for operation sequences, out of which operation sequence is optimized for a better, or you can say efficient productivity, that is to be considered. Okay, now by using generative CAPP, it is possible to construct or develop an optimized operation sequence, and it allows the rapid and consistent generation of revised plan when new process, new equipment, new method and new toolings are introduced in the system. As I have told you in the last lecture, whenever you are going to make a process plan, you have a product in your mind. The design phase has already been completed, right? The final product, the diagrams and data, everything is available with you. Now you have to plan for manufacturing by using the design data. Okay, suppose you have done this and everything is fine and everything is going in the right place, the manufacturing is on, everything is okay. Suddenly what happens, many of the customers says that this product has this problem, and the management decides to change some of the features of the product, to make some changes in the product. So you have to integrate that changes in your process plan. Now the design phase again has to be re-entered or re-assumed or re-analyzed, and again after the design phase has been completed for new product, then you have to accommodate all these possibilities, all these requirements, all these specification in your process plan as a planning engineer. So whenever this type of thing happens, it should be rapid, because you can't waste time in process planning. Okay, it should be consistent, right? So these are the requirements. So computer aided process planning, which is generative type, which automatically generates, in that case it will be rapid and it will be consistent. Okay, I hope you got the thing about generative CAPP, what is mean by generative CAPP. Okay, and it does not depends upon standard plans. As I have said, there will be no standard plan for manufacturing a simple product. There will be different options. You can go for operation sequence, you can change it, the operation sequence, you can change the plans, right? So there will be no standard plans as such. But if you go in industry, traditionally the small scale, medium scale industries, they will have some standard plans, though they are optimized, but some sort of inefficiency will be there. Okay, so to sort out that, you make a standard plan over there and use it as a standard plan for further applications of the plan in the industry. Now the generative type, it does not depend on that standard plan. What does it does? It generates what is the best possible solution for this particular operation sequence or for this particular plan. Okay, so this is how it is going to work. It does not depend upon the standard plan that you have made as a standard. Okay, now after choosing the optimum one, you will consider it as a standard plan. Okay, but it does not depend upon the standard plan. It is able to construct an optimum fabrication, as that just we have discussed. And what we are going to get, sequence of its own accord through a series of more refined and sophisticated decision algorithms. Now this is a important fact or important thing you should remember while discussing generative CAPP. What does it tells us? Refined and sophisticated decision algorithms are used. Decision algorithms. Algorithms, we have already discussed about algorithms in previous year. I think product design engineering, we have discussed about product algorithms, how algorithms work, how softwares work, how the programming is carried out, right? So there will be decision algorithms will be in the computer so that it has the ability to decide what is right and what is wrong. Okay, so it will be a refined and sophisticated decision algorithm. Okay, so this is about generative CAPP. Now, how to implement this generative computer aided process planning? How you can implement this? The logic of process planning must be identified and captured. The process planning, whatever the process planning you are going to make, the logic for that you must identify. Okay, the part to be produced must be clearly and precisely defined in a computer compatible format. You must define which is the format you require as a softwares you are going to use, and what are the different parts, and its format must be defined. The captured logic of process planning and the part description data must be incorporated into a unified manufacturing database. So the logic that you have developed in the first step and the description data that you have developed in the second step has to be incorporated, integrated, or stored in a manufacturing database that you are going to have as a manufacturing unit. This is how three-step process of implementation of generative CAPP. Okay. Now, the logic, the part one, logic, how to develop that logic, how the logic is used, how the decision is carried out regarding the logic. Now, in this case, it is called as decision logic in automated CAPP. Okay, decision logic in automated or generative type computer aided process planning, decision logic. Okay, so basically you have three techniques or three methods. First one is called as decision tree, second one is called as decision table, and third one is artificial intelligence techniques, AI techniques. AI techniques is not a part of your curriculum, so we will be concentrating on decision tree and decision table. Let's move again. See, this is a decision tree. How decisions are taken? If there is a problem, okay, the problem is being discussed at this left point. If you see here, the problem is being discussed. Just a second. Give me a second. There is a technical problem. Okay, fine. So whenever there is a problem and you have to make some decisions, you have to follow this kind of decision tree. In general, in your day-to-day life, you also use this decision tree. Suppose you have a question and you have to make a decision whether to attend a lecture or not. If yes, then there are other possibilities. If no, there are other possibilities. This is how you think in day-to-day life. Similarly, you have to think upon decision making in process planning. Now, since we are using a computer as a process planner, okay, your role is very limited in that. Okay, so computer has the algorithm. He has it has the algorithm. Say if answer is yes, then it will go towards this area. If answer is no, it will follow or go through this area. Okay, now what is the main thing in this area or in this decision tree is the conditions and actions. Suppose there is a problem and there is a discussion on decision making. If yes, then it is going over here, and these are the actions and these are the conditions. Condition 1, condition 2, condition 3. Layers of conditions has to be applied and finally we get the actions. Okay, we will see one example at the last how it is how it works. So this is called as decision tree. Second one is decision table. This is most important one because in this case, see, condition 1, layer 1 is there, condition 2, layer 2, condition 3, layer 3, and summation of this we will get the actions. What are the actions we are going to perform? So condition are written in this column, and if yes, no, yes, no, these are mentioned in this column. Actions are at the end or at the base because these are the conclusions. Okay, what are the actions to be performed that are to be found from this thing? Okay, see, this is an example of a decision table. Okay, let's see these conditions. First condition is the raw material is a casting. The answers are yes, yes, no, 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 yes. It could be variants. Okay, in result 1, result 2, result 3, you can call it as results. Okay, now is the raw material is forging? Yes, yes, no, no, it could be any answer. Okay, in other different result scenarios, okay, you can follow R1, R2, whatever different scenarios you are going to see, you can go through that. Okay, is a raw material a black bar? Yes, no, 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 like that. So these are the conditions you have to say, or you have to answer Y, yes, and N for no. Now let us see what are the actions are supposed to be taken. Allocate the material to the hacksaw blade. Which material is going to be allocated to the hacksaw blade? See, it is the is material is a black bar. Yes, then it allocate to the hacksaw material. Okay, allocate to the lathe. If the material is casting, yes, you can allocate to the lathe. Is the batch size greater than 50? No, you can allocate to the lathe machine. Okay, then allocate to the machining center. Which one is to be allocated? Is greater than 50, you can allocate this this part to the machining center. It could be automatic machining center, like that. Okay, now this is how decision table is carried out or calculated. Now you are not supposed to calculate this manually because the generative type computer aided process planning will automatically do these calculations for you. There are some softwares. These are the best softwares for a manufacturing firm, process planning firm, process planning part of that manufacturing firm. They will use that software and that software is going to work for you. But you should understand what is the basic procedure is happening in the software. Okay, so if in any problem occurs on the in the process plan, or if problem occurs in the manufacturing area or phase, you will get to know what exactly happened in the manufacturing phase. Okay, is it is the fault of planning phase, is it the fault of design phase, or is it the fault of manufacturing phase? That you can identify using the sequence that you know in your mind or the knowledge you have. Okay, so this is how decision table is used. Now the last part is advantages. It generates consistent process plan rapidly, as we have discussed. New components can be planned as easily as existing component, that already we have discussed. Whenever the new tool, new material, new design is to be incorporated, you can use generative CAPP because it is rapid, consistent, and it does not depend on the standard plans. It has a potential for integrating with an automated manufacturing facility to provide detailed control information. So for a management point of view, you will have detailed control information regarding the process plan, regarding the manufacturing, regarding the design data inputs, specification inputs that you are going to get. So basically you can have this as a package, okay, and which is very important for controlling the overall processing of the industry or the shop floor. Okay, so these are the advantages of generative computer aided process planning. So this is the end of today's lecture. I hope you understood the things that I have told you, and if you have any questions, you can just give me a message or you can mail me. We will discuss this. Since there is a lecture next to this lecture, you can just give me a second. I will take the attendance so that you can go ahead. Give me a second. Okay.